Yeah, I'm going to do a video on some of my other Caracanos I have. I already did a video on my 91 empty rifle, which is this one here, that wild back. I'll do a video on the last empty rifle that Italy produced in the Second World War, the 9141. I got two examples. This one here is my Armigera Cremona 9141, and it was the first Caracano I ever got. And it's not as complete as this one here, but it's got a bent down bowl, which it shouldn't have, and the stock doesn't match. But other than that, it's real good shape and has a real good barrel on it. And this one here is a later one I got. It's a Turin built one. It's got the correct straight bolt handle and everything. Stock matches and everything like that. And it's built 1942, so it was probably used in the war. This one here was built in 43 or after, so it was either used by the Northern Italian Republic or used by the Germans. They overran the factories after Italy they left the war in September 43 or so. And I'll just show some of the differences between the Model 41 and the 91. And you can see they both have straight bolt handles. They changed the sight when they went to the 41. They went from the bigger one was 2,000 meters to one that only went to 1,000. And the barrels are really similar. That one's 31 inches. The 41s are about 27 or so. And they're very similar barrel bands. The nose caps are very similar, just they took less time machining them. That's save time. And the same for a cleaning rod. And the front sight is pretty much identical. And you get swivel cables on the bottom for the for infantry, I guess, to use. And then they got the ones on the side, more like the carbines. And that's for, I guess, for mounts, so mounted troops could carry them. I think they were trying to replace the rifles and the short rifles they had with this sort of a from an intermediate kind of a thing. Everybody could use rifle. And the longer barrel and the non-fixed sights like they had on some of the earlier short rifles and carbines was probably better near fighting in North Africa, where some of the ranges are it's open territory. Some of the ranges are quite long for some shots. And the butt plate is different on this one. This one had two screws right in the back. This one screws on top here and one's here. It strengthens the wood a little bit. But other than that, the difference is the same action, the magazine. The barrels, they went to just a constant twist. They went away from the gain twist like in the 91 here. Apparently it wasn't the gain twist didn't help them enough that they thought it was worth keeping. The sights work the same. Just push the button in and you can run it and down. And the battle sights here, when you put that in stock, the same as that one. And one interesting thing about this one is the bolt is out of an earlier pre-World War I or World War I 91. It's got a serial number on it. And it's also got the older style little cut here where so it shows you where you're supposed to take the little tit here, because they don't take the bolt apart. And the newer bolts don't have that. But it does have the newer extractor though. The village extractors, they went along the side here and come right through the locking lug here. These don't they go up over the top, which I thought was better. It's a whole lot more of a claw anyway. They did that a lot in the Second World War. They took these out of service around before the First War or so, and had them in a drawer somewhere. And then when the Second War started, they said, well, these are perfectly good bolts, and we'll just use those, and it'll speed up production quite a bit. So it's quite common. common, I guess, in most, a lot of 40 ones. This one here, I don't, it looks almost like a carbine bolt. Bent down. It's been blued, which the Italians never did, so God knows where this one come from. Maybe it might be one of the Egyptian ones or something. No way to tell, really. Anyway, that's the main difference between the 91 infantry rifle and the 91-41 Caracanos. And I'll have to do some videos on me shooting these ones. I haven't shot them in a while. But they both have perfect barrels, and do some videos shooting them, I guess, sometime.